We have some questions, right? Okay, now, fire away.
Yes, why did God make it so hard for all of us? Because 90% of the people seem to be...
Why don't you ask him?
I don't know, but he made it so impossible for all of us. Everybody seems to be miserable. 90% of the people seem to be in turmoil.
It's really quite simple. It's not God that made it difficult, it's man. It's aren't I making it simple?
Yeah.
I mean, if it's not simple, you know, you better not do it, because you certainly couldn't do something complicated, could you? You couldn't, could you? I mean, if it was complicated, you could never do it. It's hard even to do something simple, let alone something complicated. You know, the experts will always say about Roy Masters, oh, he's too simplistic. And they don't want... haven't you noticed, even your own self, when you have an ego, that you don't do things the easy way? You do things the hard way. And if it was easy, well, you'll probably make it difficult, because if it's simple, you can't take any credit for it. So you make things complicated, and then you can get credit for it. And so the way to the truth is very simple. But you tend to make it complex for yourself. You tend to complicate your own life so you can get credit for all your achievements and accomplishments, you see, because you have a problem called ego. And ego likes to take pride in things. And if it was simple, then how can you crow? Anybody could do that if it was simple. So, but there's no pride in it. You make things complicated. And the pride of others also make it complicated. You know, teachers make it complicated for your children. It's all very simple. I'm making it very simple. So it's not God that makes everything complicated. It is the stumbling blocks are man's. The people who want to go on being the powers that be. They don't want you to find yourself. They want you to educate yourself. They don't want you to heal yourself. They want to be the source of your education. I tell you, you are subject to that source of your information. You're either informed or you're outformed. You know, the informed person is really an outformed person. And if you get your education from a source outside, then if you trust that source, then you're blocked from the internal source. You see, I say that you have an eternal flow, and the more you know, the more you can know. You know, the righteous live by faith. And faith without works is dead. You know something, you act on it, and it's very rewarding. The word becomes, understanding becomes flesh. And it becomes alive. And then the more you discover, the more you can discover. Because discovering and the acting on it builds a basis, a foundation to receive even more, like a small tree. A small tree has little leaves and only catches little bits of sun. But it produces a little bit of growth. But when it becomes a big oak tree, it's got jillions of leaves. And it feeds the big body, see? And I just tell you that when you put out the light, when you put forth the leaves and you receive a little bit of light and your body grows from that, it's the foundation, because now you put enough forth another leaf. Whoop, the more light you can bear and more understanding. And you are made of understanding. And to be made of understanding is not the same thing as to be made of knowledge. The fallen man is made of knowledge. He forgets one knowledge in place of another, because one knowledge, truth, will tell him that he can't be God. And that every person who wants to play God, everybody's playing God, believe it or not, everybody, whether they realize it or not. We want to feel that we are God. And in order to feel this way and to believe this, you cannot know anything greater than ourselves. And the minute that rejection of reality, to be reality, cuts us off from knowledge that makes us grow, that could make us grow eternally. In the light. We want to be our own light. But then we're ignorant, and our ignorance is a vacuum. It needs to be filled. And that source of that knowledge, the source of that fulfillment for ego, is professors. The letter killeth, but the spirit gives life. I don't care if it's the scriptures that you study, it will kill you. Knowledge is dead. Dead knowledge. It makes you dead. It makes you feel alive. It makes you feel like you're growing. Because it's exciting to fall for a lie. We all want to be lied to. We want to be lie-loved. We want to fill ourselves with false hopes and false spirits. That's the nature of man. Death as part as life. It's an illusion. Each high becoming a new low, each low becoming a high. Manic depressive, we call it. See? Yes.
So they're